Enots Engineering, I'm Alan. Today we're finishing the floating reamer holder. This is in the form of a kit from Hemingway, and I'll put details on the front page. This is the reamer holder. This part fits into the tailstock. This part floats, and you can adjust that amount. And the reamer goes into this end. So let's go into the workshop, see how we do it. These are all the finished parts for the floating reamer. So now we'll start the assembly. The pins have been fitted into position, and we'll start by taking the Morse taper adapter and the housing. This is one of the first pieces we made with the screw threading, and that screws onto the Morse taper arbor. That's now ready for the spring to be fitted. The spring has been cut to 1/2 inch long, and we fit that with the cut end facing down, and I've put some grease so it'll hold it in position. And hopefully the grease will hold the ball on top of the spring. There's the ball, and I'll keep it upright now to stop it rolling off. The next part to assemble is the pivot plate. I've put some grease on the pivot plate, and the slot goes over the two pins that are inside. And on top of the plate goes the pivot sleeve with some grease on it, and that goes on the top. And to hold it all together, we fit the ring with the four cap heads in. I've tightened the four cap heads up, and now I need to adjust the tension because there's no tension on that at the moment. So by screwing this in, you can adjust it till it goes tight. I've got grease on my hands. I've temporarily added the Morse taper sleeve to the wrong end, so just so I can use it to get a good grip. And now holding the Morse taper sleeve, I can adjust the tension. So I've assembled it all, except for the grub screw in there that locks it in position. This has got some play in there so it can move. So now I'll tighten this up till it locks, which is there, and back it off half a turn. It's just got enough play to move. The spring's pushing it forward. You need about 25 thou of movement. That's it, just enough play to move. Now I'll fit a copper cap in there and lock it with the grub screw. Goes down inside there. Grub screw. So that has some movement. Turn around and it can move side to side. That's all assembled. I just need to take the Morse taper off that end and fit it on the other end. That's the finished assembly with the Morse taper on the correct end. I'll take it over to the lathe to test it. We start by preparing a piece of steel ready to be reamed. First of all, we drill and bore a hole. Now I want to drill it out. This is, I think it's 2164. As long as it's smaller than the reamer. Do it about 20 millimeter deep. inches there. Now I'm using my boring bar to open the hole up so it's about 20 thou smaller than the reamer, and also it's ensuring that the bore is parallel and straight. Point 3543 is the reamer size, which is 9 millimeters, so that's 12 thou smaller than the reamer. Now I've just marked the depth I've gone into that bore, and what I want to do, I will ream half of that, part it off, turn it round, and then offset the hole and ream it again from the other side. Okay, that's trued the outside up, so when I part this off I can put it in a chuck the other way around and then offset it to a known amount, knowing that the hole will be running true to the outside. This is a setup: tailstock, floating reamer holder. On this one my reamer has a parallel diameter, so I'm holding it in a small chuck which is fitted into the end on a Morse taper. So if I hold this look, I can move the reamer around. So the first thing I want to do is put some oil on the reamer and just place it into the bore. A small amount of oil in the bore and on the reamer, and start the speed slow. And I'm not going full depth, I'm only going halfway into that bore. Hold the reamer, guide it in, and then just go in 10 millimetres. Stop there, withdraw it, hold the reamer again, take it out. Let's clean the bore out. Is a H7, 9 millimeters H7, and H7 is the standard for the bore that it will cut, gives a tolerance. So what I want to do is measure it, and I'm using this gauge. What you do is, as you tighten the screw up on the end, it draws in a taper that expands, so you get a feel on the bore. It's all about feel, and then you use a micrometer to transfer the size. You get a feel on there, and it's just over 0.355. It's under a half. So it's about 0.3553, and 9 millimeter should be 0.3543, so it's a thou oversize. Primary selection of fits, this is British standard. H7 hole, it's holes on this side, shafts on this side, should be from 0 up to, I think it's just about a thou, plus a thou, thou and a bit over. So this hole is about a thou and a half oversize. It was a cheap set of reamers, so I'm not expecting it to be exactly right, but that's not bad. Thou and a half, that's a nice fit for a dowel or a peg in a hole. This diameter is running true at the moment, So I'll part this off, turn it round, put it in the chuck, get it running about a sixth thou out, and then do the same again on the other side, go halfway in, and see if that hole is bigger. Now, if the floating reamer attachment's working, the hole should be the same size as when it's true. It should compensate for any offset and make the hole the same. That's the whole idea of it. So that's my next job. I fitted this insert parting off tool. I haven't used it for some time, so I thought, see how this compares to the high-speed steel one. Fitted a bit of brass rod in the tailstock just to catch it when it parts off. Put the dial indicator on, and that's running out 3/10. So what I want to do is make that a sixth thou offset. So I'll do that just by altering my chuck to get the sixth thou. So after adjusting some of these screws on the side, I've now got the run out from a few tenths to roughly sixth thou. So the hole is moving backwards and forwards sixth thou. Some oil in the bore and on the reamer. I want to do 10 mil into the bore, so I'll just zero my scale, start it slow, guide it into the bore and take it in 10 mil. There's the 10 mil. Take that out. Let's push that off and clean it out, and we'll have a look at the size. Once more, put the bore gauge in. Micrometer. It's couple of tenths different than the other bore, but like that could be me with the measuring. So bore size, I'm going to say it's the same. Now you can see still running out six thou. So that reamer cut a hole that was just a couple of tenths maybe bigger than a hole running true. I think that works quite well. I was expecting that hole to be a couple or three thou at least bigger due to the run out on the outside and the bore. So it's allowed the reamer to follow the bore and not cut more off one side of the bore than the other. That's the finish of the bore that was running out six thou. Still a good finish. If I turn it over, that's the finish of the bore that was running true. So I don't think there's any difference in the finish. I haven't got surface finish measuring equipment, so I can't really tell you. It just looks the same. But I'm pleased that it's cut within a few tenths of the bore that was running true. Now it shows the floating reamer attachment is moving the reamer to set it central to the bore. Oh well, that's it for today. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.